Hi, I'm Federico and I work in the robotic field application team at STIGA. We are going to install an A1500 robot and it's a completely autonomous robot and the installation is made via the app. The collection includes smaller and larger models, up to more than 10,000 square meters. The installation is the same regardless which model it is.
I take this opportunity to show you the latest version of the app that makes the process even faster.
The robot is updated with the latest firmware released in September. What's in the box? The robot, the charging station and its reference station, the power supply and an additional box, the fixing pegs, an additional support for the reference station, an extension cable, some spare blades, the manual and the safety key. Put it in your pocket and don't lose it.
We have two options. The first option is to find a really open space for the charging station.
In this case, the reference station can be left inside. The second option is when you have to place the charging station near a wall. In this case, you have to remove the reference station from the charging base. In the second case, you need to use the extension cable and the mounting bracket for the reference station.
You can decide to connect the reference station to the base, so it gets power from the base. Or you can even decide to have the reference station with its own power supply.
Today, we are going for option one for two reasons. The first one is a 120-degree sky view all around, and the second one is a power socket nearby. Connect the power supply to the charging station, like this. And then the power supply to the power socket. Green light, there we go. The next step is to switch the robot on. For this, we need the yellow safety key. And now, I need my phone. When the robot is paired and the GPS connection is set, the robot does its own calibration by self-doing three steps forward out of the charging station. Then it knows its exact location. Now we are ready to record the first mowing area. If you want, you can practice or go directly to the registration. Now drive the robot to the first starting point before starting the recording.
You can drive the robot along the perimeter. It will record every movement that you do. I move the robot to point A and fix it. Then I move to point B and select it. Doing that, the robot will draw a straight line between the points.
Let's do now the docking path. Now the basic installation is done, but let's record a second area. Now,
we run a path from area 2 to area 1.
Exclude big obstacles like this tree. There is no need to record obstacles like this. The robot will take care of them. Ciao! We are back after a week of robot mowing. Let's see the results.
Now we are creating a play area, so we have added the goal along the border.
Let's look on how to change the perimeter. It's quick and easy, trust me.
Select points A and B along the perimeter to identify the section you want to edit. The robot will automatically move to the starting point. Confirm it to begin. Now you need to guide the robot along the new perimeter. Save it and it's done. Now your perimeter is updated.
Now, to create the football area, we can use the temporary no cutting zone. Let's see how it works.
Select points A and B along the perimeter to identify the gray area. This will be the area that the robot will not cut until the selected time.
Do you want to set up a relaxing area that the robot should avoid?
Simply go to My Garden and search for the Go Away feature. Once inside, identify the desired point on the map and select it. Then use the slider to select the size of the area. The radius can be up to 10 meters. This will be the area that the robot will not cut until the selected time.
Now the robot is ready to mow. Thanks for watching the video to the end. Stay connected. Ciao.